Isn't it like 9 in the fucking morning?
Shut the fuck up.
Neon Genesis Evangelion, a true pinnacle of anime and that everyone fucking loves for some reason. Now, I'm not gonna shit on it right now, I promise, but I decided to end the year right and actually watch it for myself. So these are my thoughts, and I went into it with high praise, but I don't think it's bad. I don't. I really don't. I really recommend it to anyone, and honestly, I'd watch it again. But let's just start off slow and talk about the story. Disclaimer, I will not be spoiling any parts or major parts of Evangelion, but I will let you know there is a fish tank right beside me, and I'm not trying to smother my damn fish, so you're gonna occasionally hear noises from that. Hey, and you know what, sometimes it just be like that. Other than that, let's start with the characters instead of the story. I'll get into the story in a minute, no spoilers again, but we'll start with the main character, Shinji Ikari. He's a bit of a boy, you know. Boys do. We got mommy issues, but not Shinji. No. He's got daddy issues. I just can't relate. His father, Gendo Ikari, he's not really a good father. He abandoned him when he was young. He didn't really want much for him. But other than that, now he wants to be in his life, but doesn't really give a shit about him. Shit happens, you know. I have mommy issues. It's fine. Then you have Asuka. Asuka. Fuck. Asuka. Damn. Asuka. One of the main characters. And honestly, she's one of the more appealing characters because how entertaining she is. The show was kind of boring until she showed up. And she's one of the children that pilots the Evas. Great character. Then we have Rei, another child. She is a little bit boring, but she has such an amazing story. It makes up for it. And it explains why she is the way she is. And last but not least, Miss Misata, dude. Oh my, this one's for you. Mommy, honestly. Story, this bitch has it. Confusing, honestly. It is a good story. And like I said earlier, I won't get into any spoilers, major ones, but let me just start with the gist of it. So there's a boy named Shinji, daddy issues. Father calls, hey, Yoso, what the fuck's up? Come over, come see me. Doesn't really give a shit about him. His dad's been away working on this science project for school. You know how it'd be. Called the Evas. The Evas are big fucking robots. We don't know much about them. I won't get into that. Really cool thing. So if you like Gundam, there we go. This bitch has Gundam. Titties.
Yep.
Hentai. Almost. About that close. About 30 seconds of it. Other than that, he goes to see his father. He meets a girl named Rei. Rei is very injured. There's a thing called angels attacking. Angels are big gods that are coming down to destroy the earth. There's been two major impacts, what they call, so the world's almost died. The third one will kill the earth. But that's what their job is. They're there to defeat the angels and live on. So he gets there. Rei's injured. He decides, what's going on? And he's like, I want you to get in one of the Evas, Shinji. I made you one. It's called Eva 1. This shit looks fire. Look at this. That's fire. Purple, green. Honestly, it was a good story. He was battling with himself to get into the Eva, but he decided to get in it and immediately did not know what to fucking do. I'm glad it wasn't one of those anime things where he hops in, gets it like that, runs out there, kills everything. No, he blacks out like a pussy. I wouldn't black out. Put me in one of them. Come on, put me in one. I wouldn't. Other than that, he gets in it, blacks out. The Eva takes over, kills the first angel. That's not really a major spoiler. I just want to get into the thing. So there is some action, but only to the fourth episode because the rest of the episodes are blocked with cicada noises. And if I hear another fucking cicada in my life, I'm gonna lose it. I can't. Because episode 1 through 7, their entire soundtrack, they're like, we're not using music. No, we're using cicadas. That's what they're doing. And whoever said that probably got a promotion because people like it. I don't get it. Other than that, he's injured. but he's not. He recovers in the next 4 hours, like he has powers, but he's just a boy with daddy issues. I have mommy issues. That doesn't give me shit, besides I can't sleep at night. Other than that, that's pretty much the main gist of the story. But after he goes into the Eva, he decides to stay with them. He gets roomed with Miss Masata. Woo! Honestly, dude. Check it out. Other than that, she's a bit of an alcoholic, just like me. I don't drink, I swear. But I do. the rest of the episodes leading up to episode 7 or 8, I'm pretty sure it's 7, is pretty damn boring. I'm just gonna be honest with you. I did not like it. I don't understand why people were so obsessed with it. It was just boring and dull. Every time I found an angel come down, someone cried, someone got shot. Shinji hopped in that motherfucker, got knocked the fuck out. It killed it. Why do they even have him there? Let it do itself. But other than that, after the 7th episode, it introduces the first decent character besides Miss Misato, Asuka. I fucked that up. First try. Let's go. Other than that, she is the pilot from Germany that works with the Eva 2, one of the red Eva. Pretty fire, not gonna lie. It's more advanced than the Eva 1. It's pretty fucking cool if you ask me. Other than that, she actually puts in a character development into the other characters. She's a bit wild. She's a bit crazy. She's more outgoing. She's not afraid, and she doesn't have a lot of conflict starting off. But as it goes on, it shows more character development. She has conflict. She can't really do much. Really good story, honestly, for her. Other than that, that's just the main story. The story does pick up later. I think after episode 8, it picks up highly. But when it gets near the end of the show, and I hate to be frank here, I did not like the fucking ending. I actually hated the ending so much, it made me almost dislike the show. But I actually thought about it for a while, and it was good. I think from episode 1 to 7, cicada noise, horrible. 8 to fucking 24, great, awesome, so much shit in it. And then all of a sudden, the last two episodes are like, do you like what you've seen? We're getting rid of it. Oh. Nope, no more. That's it. Okay, so let's get to the conclusion of this. The reason why I'm doing this video is not because I want to shit on Evangelion. No, not at all. I think it's a great anime. It's mainly just to say something about it because I've always heard it's the best. Top. In the 90s, this was it. You know, and I remember being young and actually watching it, but I never thought it was like fantastic because I didn't remember a fucking thing from it. I still don't. Just kidding. I love it. But at the end of it, would I recommend it? Yeah, I would. I think it is a fine anime, and I can't wait to get the manga. I do collect manga. I read a lot more than I watch. It was very interesting. The story was very good. I think there was a lot it could pick up on, but it was made in the 90s, and there was not much to reference off of. Overall, a lot of people rated it 10 out of 10. Like fucking IGN 10 out of 10, we got paid this week, or Rotten Tomatoes 100%. And I don't think it's 100% anymore. I think it's an 80. It's still really good, and I love it. And I do plan on getting, like, fucking manga for it, t-shirts for it. But other than that, it's pretty damn good. Don't complain. I'd probably give it 80%, though. Yeah, a solid 80. Let me just say this before I leave you guys on this video. This is my first time making one of these videos, and I did enjoy it. If you don't like it, you know, shit happens. But I do plan on doing more of these. This is my first actual, I feel like I put a lot of effort into video. So if you liked it, please like, subscribe, ring that bell. I do plan on doing another one. There's some other videos, by the way. I do plan on doing another one next time. Hopefully it's gonna be Cowboy Bebop. Personally, it's one of my, probably my second favorite, maybe third anime of all time. Even manga, the manga of it is still really good. It's hard to come across, really hard to come across. Other than that, I did put a lot of effort in this, and I want to say thank you everyone who watched. I love you.
Okay.